60 Minutes Overtime.
Happy Friday.
We got an interview with the CEO of YouTube, Susan Wojcicki. The truth is, it was hard to put the story together because there were so many avenues and tentacles. Susan Wojcicki made it very clear that they're not media. They don't check the facts. They say, no, we're just a platform. We host users who send us videos. They are now developing policies to curb particularly the spouting of hate. They try to deal with the conspiracy theories. There's a lot of medical quackery. They're beginning to try and tame it. But for the most part, they say, we're not a news organization. We don't do checking the way we do.
We are in the distribution of news companies. We don't produce news ourselves. And of course, like someone out of their garage can upload a video and say their point of view about what happened with the news. But we're not going to recommend that when there's a breaking news event. We're going to recommend companies that we know have a long tradition of delivering reliable news. We decide what's on our site, but what we do is we say there are certain types of information that we know are not true, and it's harmful if people get the wrong information.
And of course, harmful is in the eye of the beholder. They come under a section of a law called Section 230. That means they can't be sued for the material that their users put up. So if you put up a video, they are not liable.
And that has enabled, it's basically enabled the internet as we know it. It's enabled us to have people upload content, not have every single comment be reviewed, not every single video be reviewed. And so it has enabled new types of communication, new types of community, new types of content that we just wouldn't have had beforehand. But it also gives us protection to remove content. That is a really important part of 230. So there's a Good Samaritan clause that actually enables us to remove content that is legal under US law, like mature content, adult content, hate content. So it actually gives us protections for that.
Her argument is constantly, we're a site where we give everybody a voice. That's who we are. That is our DNA. That is how we started and how we want to continue. Now, there's been a lot of objectionable things that have been posted, and I think that's why she agreed to give us this interview, Susan Wojcicki, because she wants the public to know they're trying to curb harmful speech on their site, hateful speech.
230 says you can't be sued for things that appear on your platform. So you have this huge protection. I know it allows you to run things, but look at all the things we've talked about that do get on your platform that have been harmful.
Which we're removing and that we're working on. And honestly, if there was laws that said, this is the type of content you can't have, then we would remove it. Just to be clear, because you've asked me so many questions about hate, that's not necessarily something that we're getting any kind of legislation about. That's allowed. That's allowed here in the US. And we are making a decision to be responsible because we think it's important for our society right now. We're allowed to do that because of Section 230. And so the government is free to say, hey, this is how you should enforce hate. This is how you should enforce harassment. We would follow those laws, but we don't see those laws. Those laws aren't out there right now.